And in for Martha, today we heard very different descriptions of the outcome from the defense and the prosecution.
While Central Florida has been peaceful, there have been rallies across the nation, some of them becoming violent. Overnight in Los Angeles, police used shotguns loaded with beanbags to try and disperse a large crowd at a busy intersection.
In New York, some unruly protesters were taken into custody.
And in San Francisco, thousands took to the streets all weekend. One group even burned an American flag.
The six jurors from the trial are still anonymous, but we have learned that one of them has signed a deal to write a book. We have live after the verdict team coverage. Michelle Meredith is standing by at the NAACP convention. But we begin with Bob Keeling of the Seminole County Courthouse. And Bob, lawyers on both sides are giving new information on the talk show circuit today.
That's right, Meredith. Mark O'Mara talking about what George Zimmerman is doing now and why he's getting his gun back. Meanwhile, less than 48 hours after his acquittal here, prosecutors are calling George Zimmerman lucky and murderer.
You had an alternative to shooting this kid.
In the cold light of day afterwards,
you have to take a bad shot.
On The View today, George Zimmerman's lead attorneys themselves were cross-examined about why George Zimmerman felt he had no alternative but to shoot Trayvon Martin.
In his mind, maybe the options weren't there besides what he did.
Now that George Zimmerman is a free man, where is he?
He is in hiding, and I think he's going to have to stay there because there is still a segment
How long does he stay there?
I don't know if he ever walks the street again, not wondering if the person coming at him or walking behind him is going to have the anger that we now see in some of the tweets and some of the information, because there is so much emotion attached to this case.
Undoubtedly, that fear is one reason why his legal team confirms Zimmerman will get back the gun he used to kill Trayvon Martin, he says, in self-defense.
Listen to what the audience, they're groaning.
Technically, under the law, he has been acquitted, he's not guilty, and evidence is returned. And that includes the gun.
Meanwhile, the lead prosecutors, in an interview to air tonight on HLN After Dark, were asked to describe George Zimmerman in one word.
Murderer.
Prosecutors were asked to do the same about Trayvon Martin.
Prey, P-R-E-Y.
And coming up all new at 5 o'clock, Mark O'Mara talks about the possibility of a civil rights prosecution on the federal level against George Zimmerman. Meanwhile, one further note, MedioBistro.com confirms that one of the jurors, B37, has signed on with a literary agency intent on writing a book. None of the others have come out of this protective shell of anonymity. Even that juror may decide to write that book, still remaining anonymous. Reporting live at the Seminole County Courthouse, Bob Keeling, WESH 2 News.
Now, Bob, you watched that juror in court for three straight weeks. Did you see this coming?
I didn't, Jim. Actually, she was really much less intensely interested than a couple of others. Certainly E6 comes to mind. The younger blonde woman, B51, the two-time retiree. So, Jim, yeah, I do find this one surprising, and it's going to be interesting to see how it develops.
Absolutely. Bob Keeling in Sanford, thanks so much. The timing and